Hi everyone, it's Rosanne. I have my Doily book video now. This is also another Nannies Attic by Nola design team project that I finished quite a while ago. I have two other Doily books that I am working on, and I think with the new pieces of Doily that I just got from Betty Jo, these are going to be really good doily book bases because they have all the fringe. So I might use four of these stacked up. I'm pretty sure I'm going to stack four of them up just like that. And then run maybe some seam binding or something right there, and then they'll be able to open like that, and I'll have all of the pages. So, thank you, Betty. I'm already figuring stuff out, and I'll probably do a process video for that one, or a series video for that one. Okay, so let me just go ahead and get my camera settled down here. Okay, there we go. This is my doily book, finally. And let me grab my... Yep, this. It is about... four inches tall. Yeah, it's about 4 inches tall. Yeah, about 4 inches. It's about, I don't know. This is 8, so 10. Six and a half by 10, as far as, you know, 6.5 this way, and then maybe 9 or 10 this way. And 4 inches thick. It's a big one. I'm having lots of fun since I've got lots of doily stuff now. And I'm going through it. making all of my doily books. And I used some of the tool that I got. Most of these, let's just say most of this, like 90% of these items that I used were all from Nanny's Attic fabrics, and I cut them into smaller pieces and scraps, and then I'll only mention the ones that were not Nanny's Attic. Other than that, everything else is Nanny's Attic. So I used tool, and that's what it looks like on the side. That's how I bound it. I put three pieces of tool. I added loops. Let me do this. I added loops to the doilies, and the doilies were right here were the square doilies that I got from Nola. And I just, they were, you know, two of them together, so I use them that way. Let's see if we can see this one. There you, I've covered them up pretty darn good. So okay, anyway, so they were two square doilies that were attached in the middle, and I made each doily a page. And then what I did was I tied in the middle the two doilies, this one and this one, with the tool, as you can see there. So we have this set of two. See how it's there? Right there, the attachment. So two pages here and then two pages here. And all I did was add the tool in the middle. And I wanted it a lot of space like that because look at how tall this is, right? So... anyway, let's do this. cutting doilies, and I'm not going to really explain too much. I'm just going to show you everything. This was from my sweet friend, Judy Dominguez. She gave me this beautiful box of goodies that I've been using. This particular half of a butterfly was from Donna Joseph, and I have used a lot of items from Donna Joseph as well. This was like a ribbon from Nola. This was some really a little piece of velvet, and I just cut it into a flower, and I want to do a flower video. How I do, this is so simple, how I do these different types of flowers, but I just haven't gotten around to it. Laces from my store, Nola, I had a couple of these little bits from a leftover from a kit I got last year, and I just cut them, these two little tassel trims. Lace from my store that's, I don't have lace in my store anymore, but these are all just, this was an applique from my mom that I dyed. I should have got water. This is my own lace, and I just created dangles, just little, this was Nola, little dangles everywhere. I added the bling. This was Nola's beautiful blouse. I cut it in strips and made dangles. This was a curtain. Actually, it's this curtain here that that Betty Jo sent me some more of. See this one? I just cut. I will be using this trim. And see, it has... Oh, I keep hitting the... I'm sorry, the camera. See, it has these types of flowers here, like this. I just cut all these out and use them, you know, I use everything. This one is a doily, you know, those long doilies. I love to use this round pictures also. And this one I just cut, added the doily in the back, and then added tulle and lace from Nola, and then more bits and pieces. But this is the first page, and you can see this one was a it was kind of like an applique, I think, that Nola cut up from a curtain, and it was more of a square, and I love that it curly cued, so I just cut the top and laid it there because I liked the dangles. And then this is some of my fiber, and this was one of the sweaters that Nola sent me, and a scrap, and this is my own. I have a bunch of this that I was going to put in the store, and then COVID hit, so I'd never put it in the store. But more fabrics. This one, Nola tied a package with this, and I just added some there. That's my beautiful, oh my god, I love this so much. I just added little bits. There were scraps. Laces from my store. On this part, some of that dangle trim. This beautiful dangle trim. So I just went around. I did all of that. I have, you know, these pieces. But, you know, when you put them all together, this was a lace from, or a tulle fabric from Nola. These were all my flower appliques. When you put them all together, they just look so pretty. All the long fibers and laces. That was a lace from my store. And just all, this was a trim that Nola scent, like a fringe trim. This was a lace from my store. So you can see all that I love. I wanted to add the pink there. And then this was the gorgeous fabric that I got from Betty Jo. It's got all these dangles. So I added a section there. Okay. And then let me show you the back. The back, this was beautiful vintage lace from my friend Janet. She's Nana JL54. And then we've got this lace and more bits. I turned this beautiful into layers of dangles, more dangles down here, laces and fibers and shredded fabrics. It's just a bunch of laces. This was from this particular lace was from NSK. This one was mine. And then more of this. This was just a whole section. Let's see. Just a whole square piece. And I just cut up in between the rows. And this one also was a fabric with squares, and I just cut it up. My beautiful, I love this so much. And I tried to cut this one, but I cut it wrong, I guess. But fibers, this was the gorgeous one that Gail's shared with me, and see, I just cut it in between here and created these long strips. So that's how I did that. Okay, so that's the back. It just looks so pretty, doesn't it? Okay, so, and I just, my little butterfly came out. Maybe I didn't have it glued. I don't know. Would I have it? Let's just put it there. Maybe I was thinking of putting it there and I didn't. Okay. So anyway, that's the front page. This is the next page. And this, I think I showed this page already, but these are doilies, my own doilies, and all I did was layer a bunch, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like 7, and then this is an applique, wedding dress applique. This is my own fringe. I had some of these strips, scraps, just more fibers and chenille fibers, just lots and lots of flowers, and then fabric, leftover fabric, and this is my trim from my store. And the filigree piece here, this huge tablecloth that I got. It's the whole base. And then I just added this here. Pieces of dangles from my store. Okay. Then this side. Hold on. It's so hard to manage when it's big like this. Okay, so this side is a heart. You know me, I love hearts. So I hope you can see that. The doily is underneath, see down here. And then I just cut out the heart in muslin. So you could see there, I left certain sides open so I could show you muslin. And then I layered all this stuff on top. So we have, you know, covered the muslin. Then we have all of these different curtain. And then this was a sweater. And then these were leave doilies. And I just layered three here. One, two, three. And then I added, you know, again, more of Gail's little trim and fabric pieces and doily bits and layers of appliques, different flower appliques. And I made flowers out of some of the ribbons that Nola gave me. And then this is more of that sweater. I think the sweater was from, I can't remember. I think it was Nola, and it had rows of this and that, and I loved this pattern. Those little, star things. This particular flower is from Judy Knows. This was from my store, This is from my store, and I just added all the... all the bling. This was one of those big doilies. And I used the peacock. See, these are... this comes from this. See this? And those I like to cut off and use them around your pictures. So that's, they come from these peacock, big, huge table doilies. I love those. And then there's this, just a piece, and then more bits of lace from my store. And then that was the leftover fringe that Nola had sent me. Or no, I'm sorry, this one came from Gail. Yeah, that one came from Gail. That's my, again, cut up doily. This is my fiber. So that's how that is. See if we can get it in frame. Okay, and then the next page. On the back side of the heart. And so this is a pocket. And I used my my daughter's wedding dress. That's what that was. This one. This is from my daughter's wedding dress. It was a scallop bottom. And I used a piece here. And these are from Judy Knows. These flowers. This was from that this flower trim here. I just cut the flowers off. This was a lace that Nola had given me, a cotton lace. This is a lace or a fabric, a blouse. From my store. This beautiful curtain I love. It was the whole base. I just love the squares. And then just little scraps that I had. This was from my store. This is from my store. And these were NSK. That's from my store. And then I have a few pieces of fiber. And this was a trim that was in my store, an antique trim I ran out. I mean, I have a little bit for me, but I don't have any more in the store. And then this was a vintage lace that I got from, I love this, Rosella. I use it very sparingly. And then that's the bottom of a big doily, of a huge, huge doily. Those table doilies, the real thin ones, I love to cut them and use them like that. So those are all those layers. And again, there's the heart. There. Okay, and then this side. This is another vintage layer of lace from Rosella. It's so beautiful. No, I'm sorry. This one came from Nola. Yep, this was the one that she sent me. This is Nola's. Yep. And I just gathered it. The whole piece. I think it was like a little under a yard, and I just gathered, or it might have been a whole yard. And I just gathered it and put it all across, you know, from here all the way down. I didn't have enough to go all the way around. But I've made do with, you know, this trim. Those are from Nola. That one's from Nola. That's that antique lace from Janet. Beautiful. I had pieces there. And then a coffee dyed piece of doily. My appliques. This was one of the doilies from Nola, and I just laid it down, gathered it a little bit, and laid it down for the backdrop. This one, it was that, it's like a ribbon or a fiber. And so I gathered the whole thing and laid it down as a base, so it's all the way around the picture on top of the doily. And then I added this trim all the way around. And then this trim, and then just flowers, more little, this one I got from Nadezda Machena. I bought some little flower doilies from her once, and she sent me this really cute little tassel trim. I always look for that when I can't find it. And then more little, that's the common one. This was from my store. There's another piece of that. And beads from my dear friend, Judy Dominguez, NSK, my lace, Nola. That was part of a curtain that Nola sent me long time ago. I just have bits left now. I love that so much. And yeah, that's it. That's that page. Underneath is this beautiful fabric or lace. And I got this one in a destash from Kim, Angel Dream Crafts. So that's pretty. I coffee dyed it. And then this is more of that tablecloth that I got a long time ago. I have bits that I use. And then this is some of my square doily. And then this is more just pieces. Just bits and pieces. So there's that. And then this is the flower page here, and you've seen all the layers here. So we have starting here, right? You've seen this one, and then there's a big doily here that I put on the base, and then there's this lace, and then all of these. This applique, again, more of that curtain that Nola gave me a long time ago, that flower curtain I love. This was a big curtain. It's a big panel that I added down there. You can see all the doilies I used. 1, 2, 3. This was one that Gail sent me that has beads on it. And then this is lace. So I left it all open so you could see how many layers. And then I'll go back and I'll just tack all that down. And we have this fabric and this fabric. And then this fabric and that fabric. And then that doily underneath. So there are a ton of layers here. Ton. You can see there all the different layers. Complete doilies. All the way around. Tons and tons and tons. Okay. So then on top, if that's not enough, we have this layer. And we have, this is a piece of fabric. And those are the little doilies that I used on this page. I just put a bunch all the way around. And then there's Nola's fiber that I put all the way around. I think I've got a little piece left. I've used it to death because of the squares. And then this is my own filigree doily. I have to re-glue that. Beautiful, beautiful filigree, fillet, not filigree. And then the beautiful fabric with the hearts. I cut circles and put it in there. And then this is another blouse, also Nola. This was a pink doily from Nola. That was a doily from Nola, this little one here. This was the outside of a flower applique. This was the outside of a one of Nola's doilies, and then this was one of the flowers that Nola gave me. And then this is a tulle flower, ribbon. I turned it, fashioned it into a bow, and then there's more of that little piece. I have a few pieces of that left. That was a lot of fun to play with. And then I have this, again, this gorgeous trim. I love this trim. Oh, so pretty. And then just all these pieces that I've already shown you. That's my doilies that I put all the way around and just little bits. Okay, so you know, you see all of the layers that are down there, right? Tons and tons. I've got to shore that up. And then the final page. And all the images are on fabric, and they have a cotton. So if you wanted, you could use them for pincushions or whatever. But just more. These are all from my store. Appliques, just laces, different laces. There's that one, and then these are just a bunch of fibers. Fiber from Gale, and these are my fibers, and that was a doily. And then this was a little tiny piece that I had left. I just added there, and again, I left it open so you could see. There's felt, and in between the felt and the picture, there's the cotton, and then there's this lace that goes all the way around, double laces. And then there's the doilies underneath. This was from my store, this beautiful flower here. It's one whole piece, and then I cut up these to put on top. And then behind that is this lace that was from my store. And behind that is this lace. NSK, and this is my lace from my store, and it's coffee dyed. Okay, so there's that. This particular one goes all the way around. All the way around. And then we come to the back. So I've already explained the back. But there is my doily book. My huge doily book with all the layers. and I hope that you all like it. I finally had a chance to film it, and this will be for sale, so if you are interested, please send me an email. I will link it, description, I mean, link my email in the description. And yeah, I've been going to the store every other week, so I'm coming up on my next store trip. So I can, once I go to the store, I can swing by. I will send an invoice via PayPal, and then I'll print out your label and then put it on the box. And then all I've got to do is just drop it in the mail. I don't have to talk to anybody. So unless it's a, you know, international, then I have to do all the paperwork. But for the most part, it will be shipped in a priority box, and I always add extra goodies, so the extra goodies will be a surprise. Okay, bye everyone. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you like my little doily book, and I've got, like I said, two others or three others started. Two others, because the third one's going to be this one, I think, and that'll be a series, the one with this. But I have to do my kit next for Nola, and I still have other projects I want to share with you guys. So, okay. Bye, everyone. God bless. Stay tuned. Please stay safe. And thank you again so much, Nola, for all of this goodness. Layers and layers of beautiness that I get to play with, and I just keep chopping and chopping. I wanted to show these. Oh, I already showed these. These are some of the... This was a tablecloth that Nola sent me that I have, you know, I've used and used and used, and I have this much left. So these are the things that I cut up and use for layers. I was thinking maybe I could use this for a book or something. I'm not sure. But I need to coffee dye them. And then this is all I have left of this particular one. It was a curtain, I think. And this one, I think I'm going to cut out the leaves. And see, if I cut out the leaves, then they become dangles. So, Nola, if you can find more of these type of curtains, especially with the squares. see, and then that could be a beautiful dangle. You know, like on the side here. Just like that. So pretty.